accepting.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, they are present. Yes. Due to informations, yes, about UFO on the internet, on books, yes, and government helped to release many of the UFO facts, yes?
Yes.
So the people are more open now to their existence. So they feel more easy to come to help us, okay?
Yes.
In any way they can, yes?
Okay. Yes.
Welcome, enlightened viewers, to Science and Spirituality. This week, we hear from Macedonian psionic or psychic researcher, Pane Andov. Throughout his life, Mr. Andov, a vegetarian, has had numerous extraordinary encounters with extraterrestrials and unidentified flying objects, or UFOs. In our two-part series, he will be discussing his metaphysical abilities, experiences with astral projection, and contacts with the universe. To spread his knowledge regarding such fascinating topics as crop circles, the extraterrestrial hierarchy in the solar system, and the coming wonderful and incredible changes to Earth and humanity after 2012, he publishes a monthly magazine called The Sixth Sense and conducts public lectures.
My name is Pane Andov, and I am a psionic researcher and contactee from a very early age. When I was 7, I was taken for the first time where my DNA was changed, and I was able to experience certain things that helped me understand dynamics that are very important for the days that we are living at this moment.
It all began one night when beings from another world came to visit young Pane.
These objects started to become closer and closer. I started to recognize that there is some kind of opening, and there are beings that are staring towards me. I started to realize that those beings are not human, but they're very similar to what was depicted in the movie Contact and Knowing. So whoever is controlling that film industry is getting information from somewhere. And the next thing that I recall is that I was taken to a room where I was closely examined, and there were all kind of laser lights that were going above my body, and I didn't feel any pain, but I had felt it warmer and colder sensations in my body as those lights were actually moving through, and it was obvious that they were doing some major changes in my DNA structure. Before they let me go, they transmitted this thoughts in my head. They told me also that they have done something to me, that I am able to experience certain things like telepathy, out-of-the-body experience and similar stuff that will help me understand what needs to be done in this interesting time. They also transmitted that they will be guiding me all the way and giving me the necessary knowledge to combine all the pieces together and to deliver this message to humanity. They told me also that there will be a major role in the process of the awakening that I need to play. The boldest thing that I remember is that they actually stated that humanity is heading towards an extraordinary change, that many spirits will return to the stars and something magnificent is going to happen. And after a while, they returned me back home in Skopje.
From that point onwards, Pane Andov began developing his newfound powers and gaining profound knowledge about our planet and universe.
I started to experience certain changes in my perception. I started to feel something more like dolphins are feeling when they dive underground, right? And I started to hear voices which were the thoughts of my mother, brother and friends around us. But the most interesting thing was the sensitivity. And if I touched something, I was able to pick up data from it, right? Like I was reading the matrix of that object in some particular way. And but the most amazing thing actually was that I was able to experience awakening where I was sleeping, but in the middle of the night I was able to see everything, to hear everything. I was starting to elevate above the bed, and as soon as I elevate enough, I recognize that my body actually is sleeping down on the bed, and I got scared at the beginning. I was thinking that I will die, but after a while I got courage because I noticed that it's not going to be anything bad, and I started to elevate more and pass through the ceilings, right? And I didn't know what to make of it then, but afterwards, after years and years, I learned that people call this experience astral projection, when the consciousness is actually using the astral body and is separating from the physical body. The interesting thing was that when I went above the roofs, I noticed that there was a light following me all the time in the background. I didn't feel any threat from that light. It was more like a protective type of light. But as a 7-year old kid, it was fun to jump from roof to roof right in the neighborhood.
As a young man, Mr. Andov practiced spirituality and further refined his metaphysical abilities.
But when I become a teenager, I was introduced by the esoteric sciences from my uncle, who was initiated into Tibetan Buddhism, into chi energy, kundalini energy, martial arts, and what yogis were able to do, staying without food and water for a long time, and to meditate and so on. And I started to meditate for hours and hours, started to explore my chi potential, started to train the out-of-the-body experience. And it took a while when I started to meditate more than 6 hours per day in the lotus position, and that's when the kundalini energy awakened and I started to experience exteriorization of the consciousness. Afterwards, my whole perception of reality shifted. I was completely transformed, and I started to look more for answers into the space and universe. No one around me was experiencing similar stuff. Those days it was very, very rare that good literature about this phenomena. I knew that this was the way to go, and my heart was pointing towards that direction. I started to lead a diary when I had put thousands and thousands out of the body experiences, where I was most of the time using awakening of the kundalini energy, and when this kundalini energy reaches my head, right, I was able to separate from my physical body and to become present on the astral plane.
Sightings of UFOs have occurred throughout human history. In many parts of the world, fantastic lights and unfamiliar flying craft have been observed in the sky. Some governments have closely tracked these events, and the UK's National Archive, the nation's official archive, has released portions of its UFO files on the internet.
The interesting thing is that I started to realize that on the astral plane there is a plenty of activity which today we would call a UFO activity. If you look outside at this particular moment with a normal camera and you record with normal visible light, you will not see much. But if you put another camera which is capable of infrared recording or night vision with some adjustments, you will realize that there are objects moving from time to time, informations, and they're not visible on the visible spectrum. As soon as you exit the biological host and you enter the astral dimension, you are able to see all these phenomena and to recognize what is happening. When I got stronger, I started to move higher and higher, but as soon as I got to 40 kilometers of height, I was hitting like an invisible barrier, like an invisible ceiling, and my astral projection was cut off immediately, and I returned back to my physical body. And I was attempting this penetration for a while. I was training with TSP cards to increase my psionic power or mental power. As it came to the point that it was stronger, finally I was able to penetrate through. As soon as I was able to penetrate out through the atmosphere and to look into the space, I started to realize that the flying crafts are coming and going from planet Earth frequently and in high numbers. And nothing of this is actually on the news. No one is talking about and people live in complete different belief systems. So this started to become very, very unusual for me, and I wanted to investigate what actually is going on with this planet. We are not aware of this activity that is going around our planet. This craft here is one that I encountered very close to the Jupiter. It was in the asteroid field between Mars and Jupiter, and the same craft is visible in many occasions around Earth, and also a boat of light that were going inside, down, landing on the planet and leaving the planet. But in those times there was no evidence to prove it. Martin Stubbs was in charge of one television station in Vancouver from the space shuttles directly to Houston, and he recorded hours of video transmission. It's on black and white because it's on infrared. They're trying to find the Mir space station. More than 100 objects are appearing on the radar and disappearing, and they cannot locate the Mir.
STS-80, or the 80th launch of the space shuttle by the U.S., is well known by UFO experts as footage from the mission shows spacecraft from other worlds.
This is from STS-80, objects that are appearing in precise formation, and there will be a central one that just low. Every time when there is a storm, above the clouds there is a huge UFO activity. Because when those lightnings appear, there is an energy that is released, and their technology is based on harvesting this discharged energy. In 2006, together with my beloved wife Svetlana Andova, we started a magazine called Šesto Svetlo in Macedonian language, or Sixth Sense in English, which dealt with Asian civilization, secret government projects, psionic research, UFO phenomena. We cover a lot of topics and increase the awareness of people in that region.
What about the presence of extraterrestrial life here on Earth? We asked Mr. Andov for his perspective.
Some of the extraterrestrials are from other systems, but they are groups of entities that are also living on planet Earth. To the best of my knowledge, we are dealing with more than 3,000 species. So some species are even older than the human species on Earth. There are species that are coming and going all the time, and there are species that are staying for some time and they leave. There are different agendas. They just avoid the contact with the human species, and they live underground in their bases, and they live underwater also. And most of the time they are just avoiding any contact. But we can see from the generated video documentation and evidence that they are here all the time.
Mr. Andov says he has been in contact with extraterrestrials since the age of 7. As the years have gone by, he has developed an ever greater understanding of their messages for the world.
I started to pick up their thoughts, and they were guiding me all the way. This image, most of it is on infrared. And this is me where I was meditating in the room. You can see the huge entity, huge orb coming from the Sri Antra. As you can see, the orb was just going, penetrating through the wall and exiting. Those orbs of light are always there, following me. So this is a seminar that I was doing in Melbourne recently. As you can see, the orbs are always following me. You will see the intelligent movement of one flying. That's the interesting part, was that as soon as I was able to tune into the frequency that I was able to transmit and receive data.
Pane Andov says that beings from other realms have informed him that the period from December 21, 2012 onwards marks the end of an age and the beginning of a new, magnificent and wonderful one. He has been told that there will be a fantastic change in human DNA that will lift our collective consciousness to a higher level. What will prompt the amazing transformation is a tremendous amount of energy coming from the very center of the Milky Way galaxy that will arrive in our solar system at the end of 2012.
this is my purpose here. I was actually in a position to communicate with these intelligences directly, like we are communicating now. And many of those messages are directed to the closing of the cycle and what we need to do, because there is a extreme energy that is coming our way from the galactic center.
Mr. Andov advocates that humanity pay close attention to crop circles, as they contain much information about the spectacular changes ahead for people on Earth.
When I started to work particularly on the decoding of the crop circles, I started to experience a direct contact with the extraterrestrial intelligence that is making the genuine crop circles. So there is a difference between the man-made ones and the genuine crop designs. And for example, with the man-made crop designs, the plant is broken most of the time by the physical force. To the best of my knowledge, more than 30,000 crop circles are delivered in the last 20 years or so. Many of those are not discovered, but the military satellites actually are picking them everywhere, and they are actually recording those images, trying to decode the messages behind them. In most occasions, those crop circles are appearing very close to the Asian horses, white horses, like depicted in the image. And as you can see in this image, they're always very close to Stonehenge, to some mounds, because those points are under something that is active from the time of the Atlantis. They're like a dimensional vortexes that exist there. That is why those genuine crop circles are appearing in great abundance. Just to satisfy the skeptic view of this, this is the best what man can do with the crop circles. This was filmed in New Zealand, so you can see there is a light that they're using, you can see from the left, and to create this stuff. And it took many hours to produce a crop circle with this precision. But after this is finished, you see they had created a huge mess with footsteps everywhere, and the crop is much destroyed and damaged. It's just completely obvious that this is done by mechanical force. The demonstration didn't match completely what was found in the genuine crop circles.
On many occasions, eyewitnesses have caught sight of balls of light hovering over fields where crop circles suddenly appear. What is the relationship between these mysterious lights and the formation of crop circles?
Flying crafts are above the field, and they are influencing the crop with electromagnetic or microwave energy. In these images here, you can see where those of light actually went through. And again, in many, many occasions, those balls of light were filmed everywhere above the field. This is the genuine phenomena that we are talking about. Take, for example, the research of Dr. Eltjo Hazelhoff. His research was about balls of light are actually creating these crop circles. He proved that this crop found inside the genuine crop circles is acting particularly in that way, like you have a light bulb in the room, and just beneath the light bulb, the source of the light is strongest. So that's where the crop is growing higher.
Dr. Hasselhoff has published a paper on crop circles in the internationally recognized science journal on plant biology, Physiologia Plantarum. Dr. Hasselhoff's work was peer-reviewed by other scientists before being accepted by the journal for publication.
he had explained perfectly about this phenomena, and this paper was actually examined by the scientific community, and it was accepted that some of the crop circles are created by a ball of light. This is the real research, that this plant was bent at almost 90 degrees, just split of the second, and also the crop grows bigger and is getting more healthier. Some of those crop circles are impressive. They're extremely big, right? And this particular one appeared in the middle of the storm when it was raining. It's amazing. If you are telepathically sensitive, you immediately feel the energy coming from these crop circles. The other thing that is very interesting, that with the genuine crop circles, once that you go inside with the compass, the compass will start to expel malfunction.
A question that frequently comes up with regards to crop circles is why the messages are not simpler to understand, and why this particular communication medium is being used. Mr. Andov says that this is because during U.S. President Dwight D. Eisenhower's administration in the 1950s, a treaty was signed between certain extraterrestrial groups and the USA concerning science and technology exchange.
So, in this treaty, there was a line that no other extraterrestrial group is allowed to directly interfere, which means no direct overtook of the television signal, no direct overtook of the radio signal, and no direct appearance and changing the course of how or where the humanity is heading. Those groups that are willing to help are writing directly to the Earth. That is why they're creating crop circles. They're not writing in English, but they're writing in the cosmic language, in cosmic mathematics and geometry. And the idea is that a certain amount of people are open to this information, and they're following the crop circle phenomena, and are working on decoding the messages. So still the message will go through. So this is one indirect way of communicating. And most of the crop circles are pointing towards the end of the cycle and the importance of certain things that people need to understand.
Supreme Master Ching Hai has given the world great insight regarding the activities of UFOs and extraterrestrials on Earth. As in this October 3rd, 2010 video conference with Supreme Master Television staff in Los Angeles, California, USA.
One of it is to help to promote peace, yeah? Promote peace. And stop war, yes? They
yes.
also stop comet to hit us, etc., etc. Yes. So you see, many times we heard
wow.
that the comet almost hit the Earth, and then it veered to the other direction, into the space, harmless space. And yes, so it didn't harm the Earth.
Yes, yes. yes.
They also heal many sick
yes.
people wherever they can. Yes, whenever they happen to have a chance to do that.
Wow.
And they also soften warlike aggression. Yes, and trying to
oh.
induce people into a more peaceful state of mind. Yes. So their activities are so many, so
Pane Andov, we salute you for helping the world gain a better understanding of extraterrestrials and their messages for humanity. May you successfully continue your benevolent work, including the sharing of your vast metaphysical knowledge with others. For more details on Mr. Andov, please visit www.paneandov.com. DVDs and books by Mr. Andov are available on the same website.